Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco and today I'm gonna be covering 5 super obvious 3ds Max features that you either knew your whole life or you discovered them just now after 5,000 years of using damn 3ds Max. So let's dive deeper into the known unknown depths of 3ds Max. Our first feature is gonna be a swift loop shortcut that I actually discovered recently. So if you go to the modeling tab, you have swift loop here. So when you activate swift loop, by the way, if you press alt 1, it also activates swift loops. For those of you who don't know, swift loop pretty much just adds loops around the object wherever you click, right? But there is a shortcut. If you hold shift, you can see how the swift loop region kind of moves, right? So shift, you see how it moves? What it does, it's going to create like a flow loop. So you can actually kind of make those smoother transitions with this. It's a super useful feature. Just look at it, like here, it shifts a little bit and you just can add like additional details. It's a very nifty feature. Our next feature is going to be set as new default. So this is actually a pretty, like fairly new feature. So take a look at this. Whenever you create a plane, for example, you're gonna have a plane that has segments 4-4. What you can do now in Max is you can change those to 1, for example, right click and click set as new default, right click again, set as new default, and look, now I'm gonna reset my Max, open a brand new scene, and now when I'm gonna be creating a plane, it's gonna be created as a single polygon plane. So yeah, you can pretty much set up new values for a lot of things. In general, you can pretty much go to any numeric value, and whatever you set there, you can always right click and see if set as new default feature is available. And the cool thing is, this thing is also applicable to material editor. So look at this. If I open up material editor, I got my Corona material here, and let's say I don't want my base color to be this value 186, I want it to be 220 because that's my maximum white color. So what you can do after I've set the 220, just right click, set as new default. And now every time when I create new physical material, it's gonna automatically be created with that value. It's pretty much whatever you wanna modify, just right click and see if set as new default option is open. Our next feature is gonna be outline selection of existing polygon selection, if that makes sense. So I got the sphere, I'm gonna, you know, create a weird looking selection. Let's say something like this. Now, if you just wanna create like an edge selection off of this selection here, there's actually two ways how you can do that. One way is go to your ribbon, to your modeling tab, click on modify selection, and you have outline here. Now, if you click outline, it's actually gonna select these polygons as an outline. But if you go to modify selection, to outline, and click shift outline, it's actually gonna create an edge selection of your polygon selection. Another easy way to do that, let me just, you know, create a new selection. Okay, this one. You know when you want to convert a polygon selection to vertex selection or edge selection, you're just going to hold control and, you know, click on edge, it's going to select all the edges. Well, if you just click shift on the edge mode, it's also going to do the edge selection. Our next feature is going to be preserve modifier. So preserve modifier is super powerful modifier. So what it does, whenever you deform your object, the preserve modifier will preserve the original topology and the structure of your mesh as much as possible without you pretty much, you know, overstretching things, destroy your object, etc. So let me show you this. So I got my sofa here and I need to do an edit on a seating cushion and I'm gonna make some deformations here on this part. So for the whole thing to work, I first need to clone this object because that will serve as a reference for the preserve modifier. So this is how we go about it. Click on your object and do modifications that you need. So let's say the modification I need to do is this, and that, right? This is my modification because I think this looks better. Okay, but what you can see happened, I got this nice topology flow here and I got these polygons super stretched. So what you can do, select your deformed object, go to modifier list, type preserve, hit enter and pick original. So click on the pick original and click on your original sofa. Now, nothing happened because there is one thing that you need to click, and that's invert selection. If I understand correctly, this modifier, it's obviously designed, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, it's designed for affecting selections and not entire objects. So it's kind of, you know, by default, it's taking in consideration that you have some sort of a selection, but since I don't, I have to click on invert selection and therefore it will select my whole object. But look what happens. Invert selection, so pay close attention to how these polygons are stretched. Invert selection, boom, you got this. See that? before, after. So it kind of relaxed the whole thing, smoothed it, moved the polygons, etc., you know, but trying to preserve the shape in which you deformed it. So it's pretty much trying to mimic the edges that are visible here, like the density of the edges. It's trying to mimic it there. You also have its intensity. Like if you go to zero, you can see that's your original thing and you just can move it, you know, one by one. And you can see how it's kind of preserving the shape, but also going back to the original topology look. So yeah, you know, it obviously does some weird things, but you know, that's max. That's how things usually go. But yeah, this is what this modifier does, and I started to love it a lot. And our last feature is the feature that I thought that absolutely everyone knows, but people still don't know it, and that's the filter selection. So selection filter here. So what does that do? If you want to set up your lights, like only all your lights in your scene, so instead of you clicking on them here and searching them in the layers, what you can do, you can just go to selection filter, click lights here, and pretty much just select everything, and boom, only the lights are going to be selected. If you want to select only your cameras, just click on the cameras here, control A, and it will only select the camera in the scene. And as you can see, you can go geometry, shapes, lights, cameras, helpers, warps, etc. So yeah, this is a, you know, small thing, and if you didn't know about it, I think it's going to make your max life even better. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you learned something new today. If you have a tip on your own that you want to share, you know, share with the community, please write it down in the comments. And as usual, see you in the next video. Bye.